Now we just saw that solubility of a gas depends on the pressure above the gas. Fine, but as it happens, we'd like to quantify that. So we just said that the solubility of a gas in the liquid is directly proportional to the pressure above it. That means in the gaseous phase, right? Fine. Now, what happens? This was actually given by a fellow called Henry, and hence it is known as Henry's law. He said it for multiple gases that are present. So, say this is a piston, and with some weights over it, okay, and it has some gas particles over it. Okay, and some have obviously seeped into the liquid. So like that. So he says, Henry's law states that at a given temperature, the solubility of a gas in a liquid is directly proportional to the partial pressure of the gas above it. Okay, so that is equal to the partial pressure of the gas above it. Now we know. So he is maybe talking about That is the other gas. There may be two gases present. That's why we are talking about the partial pressure. Otherwise, what happens? If there is only one gas, it becomes the absolute pressure of the gas. Correct? Now, at around the same time, Dalton concluded the same thing. And you must be knowing Dalton by the name of the Dalton's law for partial pressure, is it not? What did that law say? That law said that fine, this partial pressure is actually dependent on what? It is dependent on what? It is dependent on the mole fraction of the gas, is it not? Partial pressure is dependent on the mole fraction of the gas. So he modified it this way. At a given temperature, the solubility of a gas in a liquid is directly proportional to the mole fraction of the gas of the gas above it. Hope you are able to relate that. See, the mole fraction and the partial pressure, they are not two different things. They are the same thing. So suppose the red dot has a mole fraction of x1, okay, and the green dot has a mole fraction of x2, then we know that what is my partial pressure? My partial pressure p1 will be x1 divided by x1 plus x2 into p total. Now x1 plus x2 will be what? 1. It's not. So we know that, so p1 is equal to x1 multiplied by p. Similarly, p2 will become what? x2 into p. This is derived from the gas law, ideal gas law. Ideal gas law, which says, see, it says PV, this is P total, right? Suppose there are, say, three gases. There are three gases, so P total into V is equal to N total into RT. You get that? Now what is that? This is equal to N1 plus N2 plus, say, I'm taking only 3, we can extend it to N, right? So N3 RT, correct. This is P total into V. Correct. Now what is this? This is N1 RT plus N2 RT plus N3 RT. We get that. or just wait a minute. So I can say that P total is equal to N1 plus N2 plus N3 upon V into RT. Now what is this equal to? This is N1 RT upon V plus N2 RT upon V plus N3 RT upon V. Now this has the unit of pressure. You understand? This has the unit of pressure. So what is that equal to? What is that equal to? This is equal to P1 plus P2 plus P3. Why? What I am trying to say, at the same temperature, in the same volume, that means if this gas, which has N1 moles of it, there are three gases, number of moles N1, N2, N3. If this gas was present in the same volume at the same temperature independently, it would be exerting a pressure of P1. And if it was present, if the second gas was present in the same volume, that means you empty the container, keep the volume same, you put in the second gas, what happens? You put in the second gas, what happens? The pressure becomes P2, correct? You again empty the container, put only N3 moles of the third gas, same temperature, same volume, same. That means volume in which all the three are present. You keep the volume the same, the pressure becomes P3, correct? This is what is called the partial pressure. This is called the partial pressure, correct? This is the partial pressure. These P1, P2, P3. So what does it mean? The total pressure is the sum of the partial pressures. Fine. Now there is an interesting thing that you will understand. So what happens? This P1, what is this P1? If I want to know what this P1 is, how do I get it? See, it is RT upon V, is it not? This is RT upon V. What is RT upon V? RT upon V is actually P total upon N total. Do you see that? So this thing I'm writing here. So this becomes P1 into RT upon V. So RT upon V is P total upon N.
And total.
Wait. Hold on. This is N1, I am putting it here, okay? N1 into RT upon V is what? P total upon N. N total. Okay? Again the same thing. N2 into P total upon N total. Plus N3 into P total upon N total. So what happens? This is N1 upon N total, which is?
X1.
P total, X2, P total, N2 upon N total is the mole fraction of gas 2, and this is the mole fraction of gas 3. So it is nothing but a simple jugglery of the ideal gas equation which yields you this. There's no magic about it. It's not so difficult to understand. Correct? That's what? It is this which is P1, no? So this is P1, ultimately. No? This is P1, no? So you understand? So what he is saying is, this is partial pressure. Since partial pressure is directly proportional to the mole fraction, this fellow is talking in terms of mole fraction. After all, that is the gift of Dalton to the world of chemistry, no? So he is talking in his own language. They are talking about partial pressures. He is talking about mole fractions. No difference. No difference at all. Hope you understand. Fine. Now,
Now, do I erase this proof?
Okay.
Fine. Now what happens is this.
So hope you understand. Hope you understand what is being said.
Fine.
X1 into P, no? P is the total pressure.
P added P1 and P2, right? P added P1 and P2.
Where? No, here.
That above P. P1 is equal to X1 by X1 plus X2 P2.
No, this is not X1. This is kind of N1. No? Mole fraction.
That's what?
N1 upon N1 plus N2. Sorry. N1 upon N1 plus N2. Fine. And that is x1. Fine. However, this is what Henry said. However, Henry's law as we know it, so Henry's law is stated in the converse form. Earlier what it said, that the solubility, here they are trying to tell us that solubility of gas is directly proportional to the partial pressure in vapor phase, is equal to its partial pressure, is directly proportional to the partial pressure in the vapor phase. But the Henry's law, this is what, maybe say, you can say something else, because what I'm going to write now will become the Henry's law. Okay, so you can say this as Henry stated that. Fine, this is what he stated. But somehow, while formulating the law, they have reversed the thing. What do they say? Here, this you understand? The solubility is directly proportional to the partial pressure in the vapor phase. Now, more the solubility of gas in the solution. That means the mole fraction of the gas in the solution form will become more. If more of the gases go into the liquid, what happens? It means that its solubility here will increase. And what happens if solubility increases? Then the mole fraction of this gas in this solution form will start going up. So we just now said that solubility will increase if the partial pressure of the gas here is more. But while stating the law, they reversed it and they say that the partial pressure of the gas here is dependent on the mole fraction of the gas in the solution form. You understand that? Okay? You understand that? So they say that the partial pressure of the gas in vapor phase is proportional to the mole fraction of the gas in the solution. So you understand, this is what he said. What did Dalton say? Let me write that. So Dalton says solubility of gas is directly proportional to the mole fraction. Here they say that the pressure of the gas in the vapor phase is directly proportional.